Inadequate clean water sources in River Oli Division is posing health risks to residents of the area who instead use water from natural sources like streams, pooled rainwater, and hard dug wells. Officials attribute some of the factors limiting many residents from accessing clean water sources in the division to poverty in households. However, hand-dug wells, sometimes known as well tubes, have become more suitable source of water to many because individuals have invested to dig them, although health officials largely disapprove consumption of water from it. While taking Oli B cell as a sample, the cell is discovered to be having about 17 hand-dug wells with only two boreholes, one of which is already breaking down. Miss Maneno Neima is one of the women in the cell who use hand-dug well as water source to rely on for most of her household consumption.
We have had a lot of water challenges in this cell when this well was not there. We used to fetch water from Danida and a borehole up there. You wake up to go for water at 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. and you come back at 11 a.m. This sometimes generates misunderstanding between me and my husband because he thinks I have gone for other issues. Many times children go to school without taking tea because there is no water. When the well was dug, we started getting better access to water. There are many people who fetch here.
She said her family also drinks this water after it being filtered with a clean piece of cloth or after boiling it.
We also drink this water apart from using it for cooking and washing clothes. We are calling upon the government, if possible, to have for us a borehole near here.
But other women in the cell, like Miss Benti Hamida, they resort to using pooled rainwater to wash clothes. This is because Hamida wants to save water she gets or buys from borehole or National Water and Sewage Corporation for drinking or cooking.
The way we suffer here because of water is too much. When there is rain, we use the pool's rain water to wash clothes. But when rain season is over, getting water becomes more difficult. We don't sleep because we have to go for water at 4 a.m. The water point is almost a kilometer away. And this makes us to fall sick with malaria because of coldness.
The two women called upon the government of Uganda to consider installation of more boreholes in their cell. Miss Ajiba Ejiribi from Oli B cell, who is in her 60s, established one of the hand-dug wells on her compound with the help of her son. She said she dug the well because of the suffering people in her area are going through, with less response by the government to think about challenges these locals face.
This is why I propose to sink the well. I have no legs as my knees have problems to go for water in distant places like the borehole up there. The water people fetching that borehole cannot suit the population fetching it. I sank this water because of the people. I used over 10 million shillings to sink it with aims that people fetch without being charged. The only thing people do is to buy a 5-liter jerrycan and a rope to scoop the water. I did it just because people are suffering. If government can only pump it up into a big ground for people.
Government had the money. I'm with Pamela. People are just ambogorugale. But it had the sayula more. It had the
Oli Division Chairman Mr. Mozaidi Kemis said the hand-dug well has also contributed to loss of lives, especially among children in Oli B cell, where a child recently drowned in one of the wells and died.
The well tube, that is very common in the River Oli division. As the chairperson of the division, I want to come out with this one so clear. This source of water has caused loss of lives. Children have drained. I've received death cases from this. I've received death cases from this source of this water. There was a time I took very decision, I pronounced myself, of closing all these sources of water, of being so dangerous to human beings. Because they were left open. The way they were closing them was not okay. It was until others came to take decision, they built a top and they made a cover-up and they were locking it.
While elaborating that Oli division has several of these wells, the chairman said politicians and technocrats of the division have been sensitizing people about dangers of these wells, but the population is sluggishly responding to the change. Arua Municipal Council Health Educator Ms. Rose Akao said hand-dug well is a water source that the Municipal Council has prohibited for people to consume rather than considering it for washing clothes and for animals to drink. She said just like hand-dug wells, boreholes in urban settings have risks of being contaminated in cases where latrines are not situated 30 meters away from a borehole. She said water source that municipal has recommended for people to consume is the one sourced from National Water and Sewage Corporation.
Hand-dug wells. These water sources, they are still existing mostly in Oli division. For us here in municipal, the water sources that we recommend are this one from National Water and Sewerage Corporation. First of all, we are in town where the contents of the toilet and the settlement is very congested in Oli. So there is likelihood of the content of the toilet mixing up with these hand-dug wells because there are no serious protection of water. The community just digs them from the ground and as the water start oozing out, they use it. However, there are some other places who are still using boreholes. We cannot rule it out, although it is also not so much recommendable in town. We do water quality surveillance, whereby we go to the water sources, we pick the water samples, then we do water analysis, basically to get the E. coli. Our results have shown that those water sources are really grossly contaminated. However, we have gone to Oli also several times to tell the community that they should not abandon using these water sources. But you know, with the changing of the attitude of the community, we are constantly doing sensitization there to tell them that that water source is actually not good for consumption. With time, we shall abandon such water sources. We shall go and fill in, destroy them.
She said a time is coming when the municipal authorities will close these wells, something that they cannot rapidly implement now as they consider to first indulge in community dialogue. She confirmed that Arua Municipality's safe water coverage stands at 60% as many households and communities are now accessing water from National Water and Sewage Corporation. She disclosed that diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, and typhoid are possible diseases that population from Arua municipality suffer from, and the cases are more from areas where people consume unsafe water. She then urged the people using water from boreholes and hand-dug wells in the municipality to better boil it or treat it with chlorine tablets in order to destroy disease-causing microorganisms contained in such water. Arua District Water Officer Mr. Stephen Obitre explains that installation of a borehole is recommended to be in a distance of 50 and 30 meters away from latrines in sloping and climbing areas of a home. He said, dense settlement explains a reason as to why water from boreholes and wells in municipality are easily contaminated. He said on top of contamination from latrines, there are household activities like disposal of solid wastes that encourages contamination of water sources because the wastes later decompose to get their ways into the ground, hence entering into wells.
The municipality, ideally,
everybody is supposed to have access to safe and clean water. And currently, the water is there, but the challenge is access. The challenge is poverty levels. Those living in slums, take only people are just surviving on the few existing boreholes. That's why when you go down to Oli, you find very many hand-dug wells being shunk. Ideally, those people are not supposed to use those wells because of quality. These hand-dug wells are dug at low-lying areas in wetlands. You know, wetlands are areas where surface runoff water is finally discharged. And the surface runoff water comes with everything it gets on the way. That, you know, these hand dugs are dug in places where the water table is up. Yeah. We call it overburden. This is soft soil. The water we are interested in is the water which is in the rock itself. That's why the level of contamination in boreholes is low. Because the water we are getting is quite down, it is in the rock. Even if rainwater goes, splashes around the borehole, which is in a raised place, it will take time for this water to percolate through the rock down into the water column. It will take time, unless the borehole water is tapped from this soft formation I was explaining to you, overburden area. Because overburden area is so soft that once this surface runoff water is discharged, it percolates very fast into the well tube, and then you see the color of the water changing, and then when you pick the sample for test, you definitely see it is contaminated. That's why if we go to health facilities, you still get cases of typhoid high, cases of red eye, skin disease, watery diarrhea, you know, all those sicknesses that are as a result of consuming contaminated water. Fecal matter can be able to escape and get into the well tube. That is true. That explains why there are standards. If the community is up, the borehole is down, then it has to be, the borehole has to be 50 meters away from the nearest latrine. It is calculated that at least over 100 years for this material to move over that distance. So it is assumed by the time this thing could move to reach the boreholes could have outlived its usefulness. It could have been decommissioned. And if the community is down, the borehole is up, you can leave allowance of only 30 meters. Because what is in the pit cannot climb upwards, it goes downwards. So even if some organisms try to find their way moving upwards, it will take them longer time. And this explains why the boreholes in municipality are also contaminated. Because people don't have that land in town.
According to 2019 projected population of Arua municipality, number of people has shot to 68,800, with 46,800 people living in Oli division alone. The rise is from 61,946 people in 775 and 80 households in the 2014 National Population and Housing Census, out of which 60% of the population in the 2019 has access to safe water and the rest still grappling with unsafe water sources.